Do you rely on online reviews when booking a holiday or when going for a meal or buying an app or looking for a book to give someone for Christy? Well, it seems that the reviews that you're reading might not be worth the paper that they're not written on because they're online. There are a growing number of businesses advertising online offering to pay people to write positive reviews for them.
So should we stop paying attention to reviews, or are there ways to work out who is for real? To discuss this, we are joined by the food blogger Tang No, who writes Noodlies.com, and the editor of CNET Australia, Seamus Byrne. Good morning to you both.
Morning.
Good morning.
Now, Seamus, how widespread do you think is this practice of hiring fake reviewers?
I think it's pretty widespread. You know, I think it's been the kind of thing that we sort of feel like has been out there for a very long time. And I mean, it crosses over both commercial things and then like political discussions online, you know, certain commenters who will just go out and try to say the same things everywhere. So it kind of generally gets called astroturfing. You know, it's like grassroots. It's like a grassroots campaign, but it's fake.
That's fun.
Yeah. So, you know, so it's right out there and across everything from hotel reviews, restaurant reviews, right through to, you know, app reviews, all that in technology too.
And of course you get people writing their own reviews under pseudonyms. I mean, there's a famous case recently of the British author who was slagging off his contemporaries and writing glowing reviews of his own books. is there anything you can do to in any way police who is writing the reviews?
Well, one thing that the ACCC's been moving to do is really make companies aware that they're responsible for every promotional statement made about their company. Mm-hmm. And they're now including even things like their Facebook page, so that even if it is a fan who's just sort of written a gushing appraisal of, you know, something that's recently happened, they've said, if there is something that's inaccurate about that, then you need to remove that from your page. Mm. And so I guess they're trying to just make sure that systems are being put in place by websites and different companies to make sure that they accept the responsibility for these reviews.
Mm. Yep.
Okay, Tang, do you think that these fake reviews now discredit genuine websites like Urban Spoon, like TripAdvisor, which are really quite handy?
Well, I think they do in a way, but I think people more and more realise that there are people who do this, and, you know, the more publicity there are, the better. But having said that, I think if you look, again, the world before we had TripAdvisor, what did we do before we did that? We actually went to the travel agent and to get a brochure. And what hotels were in that brochure? Hotels that had deals with that travel agent and that airline.
Yeah.
And you had, you know, a limited range of hotels that had deals with the airline. Now you go to the world of TripAdvisor and you've got not just a handful of hotels, you've got a whole range of hotels. Mm. So I think, you know, there's a bit of a chill pill that everyone needs to take. I mean, I think implicit in that is the assumption that, you know, we're all too stupid. We read these things and we've got an idea. Whatever we read, we believe. I don't think people are that unsophisticated.
It's really interesting, isn't it? Because you have to be quite selective, pardon me, I think, about which websites you're looking to for advice. Because even reviews that aren't paid for, you know, you can't necessarily trust them. Because someone says it's a terrific restaurant, I mean, that person may have no palate whatsoever. Because they say 50 Shades of Grey is the best book they've ever read. Well, how many books have they ever read? You know, you've got to be pretty selective, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, it definitely comes back to, you know, what kind of information are you looking for and trying to find things that you actually feel you can agree with. And often it comes down to, you know, just don't, you know, don't just sort, say, you know, give me the best hotel by score. You know, it's like,
yep.
Now actually have a look at the writing and, you know, read what people are saying about it, because it might be that everybody kind of likes it, but there's one thing about it that is actually the one thing that you always hate.
And
so look for the things that actually are going to reflect your interest.
Yes, and look at the pictures. Tang, have you ever been offered cash to do anything? Like to write a review that's not...
Not anything, just to write a review.
No, well, I've maybe sometimes anything's better than that.
Once you write the review after. Five stars. A must pash.
Well, it depends on the we food bloggers regularly get free meals. I mean, I don't accept money to write a review because if you go to Noodlies, actually you've got a code of ethics, and I think it's really important when PR companies and restaurants come to me and say, look, we like to invite you to have a meal here, I like them to know what they're getting themselves into and to be clear at the beginning.
Is it possible for you to be objective, I mean, as a food writer, when someone has provided you with a meal and fine wine, or as, a travel writer, when you've been, you know, flown to Morocco and put up in a hotel for it, is it possible to be objective?
It's a good point. I do this, you know, I have two or three meals at least a week, and after a while it becomes your job. So, you know, while it's nice that people are looking after you, you really do look at, you know, the ambience of the place. You look at how the waiters are serving other people. And I think it's not, the thing that I'm really keen to stress is not, it's just not food bloggers or bloggers generally. You pick up the web page of the Fairfax today, you know, the Herald, The Age, Brisbane Times, go to the hotel section, the travel section. They had an article on the four hippest hotels in Bangkok. And at the end of it, it was all provided free by the hotel.
Yes.
So
yeah,
it's not like a new thing.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, if we can trust traditional media to do it, I think more and more you can trust people online, respectable bloggers, because, you know, we have a reputation to uphold as well.
Okay. Good on you, Tane. Thank you.
Very
and Seamus, always lovely to see you. Cheers.
You too. Cheers.
Thanks, guys. Now,